And welcome to the family entertainment edition of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? I'm sure you're keen to get into that hot seat, so let's get started. Okay, let's take a quick check on the rules. Up to four of you can play the game, and each of you will need to choose adult or junior questions. Then, for the first time ever, you'll be able to choose the type of questions you'd like to answer. There are three categories: general knowledge, entertainment, and sport. Simply choose one and stick with it. All you need to do then is answer the 15 questions that stand between you and a virtual £1 million. As always, you can walk away at any time, and there are the usual three lifelines available to you. Ask the audience, 50-50, and phone a friend. If you make it all the way to a million, you could be jetting off on a luxurious family holiday by entering our competition. So grab your remote control and let's play Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Select the difficulty and category of questions you'd like to play. So, you want to answer the traditional general knowledge questions. Good choice. Let's see how far up the money tree you can go, starting with five questions to get you up to £1,000. Have a look at question one. £200 if you can get this right. It's early in the game to be giving me a wrong answer, but you haven't. You've given me the right answer. Well done! Now, you've not used any lifelines, so they are still all available if you need them on this £300 question. £300, well done. Question number four is for 500 quid. Well done. Four correct answers in a row now for you. This is the last chance that you could leave us with absolutely nothing. Please don't do that. Here comes question number five. You had £500. You now have £1,000. It's the right answer. That's what I like to see. Five correct answers and £1,000 safely in the bank. This is where things hot up a little bit, though, as we try and turn that £1,000 into at least £32,000. Here comes question number six. Now, remember, you still have all three lifelines remaining. Is that your final answer? You've just won £2,000. It was the right answer. Very well done. You've yet to touch any of your three lifelines, and a correct answer here will win you £4,000. Lots of luck. Here comes the question. You had £2,000. I can tell you it was the right answer. You doubled your money to 4,000. Well, I like games like this. You're on £4,000 and you have all three of your lifelines still intact. You are just three questions away from the next milestone. And the first of those questions is worth £8,000 and is coming up now. OK, you want to ask the audience for a bit of help. Audience, I hope you know the answer to this one. Serious business. Grab your keypads and all vote now. Well, it looks like B is the popular choice of the audience. You asked for their advice. Are you now going to use it? OK, you risked £3,000, and you were right to risk it. You now have £8,000. You're just two correct answers away now from guaranteeing yourself £32,000. The first of those two questions is worth £16,000. Now, you do not have to play this if you don't want to, but you do have a 50-50 and a phone-a-friend available to help you find that correct answer. Best of luck. Here it comes. I have to ask you if that is your final answer. Okay, that is your final answer. And it's the right answer. You've just won £16,000. Right, this is a very serious moment. You have £16,000. If you do get the next question right, you'll definitely be leaving with no less than £32,000. Give me a wrong answer, though, and you have to take a drop of £15,000. Not good. I really do wish you the very best of luck. Here comes question number 10. Are you sure you want to risk all that money? You had £16,000. You could have walked away with that. I have to say, though, you were right not to. You just won £32,000. Right, you can relax a bit now, mainly because you cannot lose anything by giving me the wrong answer to the next question. If you give me a correct answer, I'll double your £32,000 to £64,000. And if you don't know the answer, you still have a 50-50 available, or you can phone one of your friends for a bit of help. The very best of luck. Here comes question number 11 of a possible 15. Well, you had £32,000. You now have £64,000. What a performance this is turning out to be. Brilliant. £125,000. It's a lot of money, and it's what I could be giving you if you can give me the right answer to the next question. You do stand to lose the £32,000 you've just won if you do give me a wrong answer, though, at this point. Here comes question number 12. OK, you want to use your 50-50 lifeline. Computer, can you take away two wrong answers for us, please? Your chances of winning £125,000 are simply 50-50. And you picked the right answer. Well done. Did you really think when you started out that you get to the point where I would be asking you a question for £250,000? Probably not, but it is about to happen. Please, please do not give me a wrong answer and phone a friend if you aren't totally sure of your answer. Let's see what happens as we look at question number 12. You could be about to become a quarter of a millionaire, or of course you could be about to lose £93,000. You've just given me the right answer. Terrific, you could now go all the way. Well, things are still going very well indeed. You just keep giving me the right answer and I keep handing you bigger and bigger and bigger sums of money. I do have even more money that I could give you, starting with a virtual cheque for £500,000, but only if you can answer this next question. Well, I don't blame you for using a lifeline if you're not sure. Pick one of your friends and we'll give them a call.
B seems like the best answer, but I wouldn't have guessed without the choices. I'd maybe go for B if I were you.
I bet you wish your friend was a little more confident. Are you going to use their suggestion or make a guess of your own? I must say, I love it when people play these big questions. You had £250,000. You now have £500,000. Fantastic! Right, here we go then. This is your one and perhaps only ever chance to win £1 million. You have no lifelines left, so you are either going to have to make a complete guess or, of course, you may well just know the answer. I should remind you of the massive amount of money you could lose, but think of what you could win. The best of luck. Everybody here is rooting for you. In which year was the Golden Gate Bridge in San Francisco completed? 1917, 1927, 1937, 1947. And I have to check that you are really going to play this question. Is this your final answer? Amazingly, you've decided to play the £1 million question. Now, you could have walked away with £500,000, but instead, you are walking away with £1 million. You're a winner. Fantastically well done. Not only have you won £1 million, you've also got the chance to enter a draw to win a fantastic, all-expenses-paid family holiday. Just text the winning code to the number on your screen. Very well done, and thanks for playing the Family Entertainment Edition of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire?